Harvard Elementary.
Good morning, Gary.
Come on up, guys.
How's your summer going?
Good.
Oh, gosh. Get out.
Something's creaking when I'm sitting down. Hey, guys. You know, pretty soon we're going to start Sunday school. Won't be too long. What do you think is the strongest part of your body? Yeah, which muscles? Yeah, your muscles, right? Well, that's a good part of your bones. It's going to be very strong, especially when you've gotten healthy now. They could also be pretty weak later, but that's a whole other problem. All right, bones are strong, but they're not strong like they don't do anything other than hold your body together. I mean, they're strong like you can't break them very easily, right? But where do you get your strength from? Your strength, the power to pick up things, move things, push things, swing at things. Where do you get that from? Where do you get your strength from? Your muscles, right? You get it from your muscles. Which muscles in your body do you think are the biggest? Not your calves, you said, nah. You're getting close to that. What is the thighs, yeah. The one right on top of the leg. And both of these, just your legs in general, are actually your biggest muscles. And they always will be, no matter how big you get here, probably your muscles are gonna be bigger on your legs. Because they gotta carry your whole body and they carry it all day, right? And they let you run and go all around. But you know what the Bible says is the most powerful muscle in your body? Doesn't say anything about it being your legs. You know what it says it is? I'll give you a clue. The tongue. Because this little tongue can do powerful things. You know, people speak with their tongues. And if you're the captain or the sergeant general or the king, when you speak with your tongue, whatever you say, that's what people do. That's power. That's power. Armies and wars have happened because someone says with their tongue, "We're going to war." And then they do. And people have been hurt because of what comes out of your tongue. And they're hurt worse than when you hit with your muscles. Because this little tongue is a dangerous little thing. Oh, can eat food and enjoy things. And it can speak wonderful things. "Mommy, I love you. Daddy, I love you." Or, "Do you love me?" Someone says yes, and it makes you feel good inside, all because of what's spoken by the tongue. But a lot of bad things can come out of that mouth too. I have a little song for you I want you to hear. It's a wonderful children's song, but I think the adults will enjoy it too. Listen to the words. It talks about the tongue. Give me 1 second.
Encourage a friend of the tongue.
remind you of a song that you might already know.
Do you ever hear the song?
Oh, be careful, little eyes, what you see. Or any of that? You guys heard that before or not? Well, there's one verse that says, oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. For the Father up above is looking down in love. Oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. I gotta be careful because everything's in my way. So I wrote a couple extra verses. It goes like this. Oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. And then it repeats. So if you don't know the words the second time, you'll know it, okay? So let's try that. I'll sing the first part, and you sing it right back the same thing. Oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. Ready? Oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. Then the verse is, for the Father up above is looking down in love. Oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. When you tell a lie, you might hurt a friend. When you tell a lie, you might hurt a friend. You might make your friend cry from that tiny little lie. Oh, when you tell a lie, you might hurt a friend. When you do something wrong, tell the truth. When you do something wrong, tell the truth. For the truth shall set you free from all disharmony. Oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. With a tongue you can worship the Lord.
What's that?
With a tongue you can worship the Lord. You can praise His holy name, and in that there is no shame. With a tongue you can worship the Lord. So be careful, little tongue, what you say. So be careful, little tongue, what you say. Good words, to speak kindness and love, and to love others. And forgive me when I speak badly, and help me to change that. Amen. All right, guys, have a good day. Sit down. I'm going to talk a little bit more about the tongue in just a minute. Not now. Here, let's go back. You listen, though. This is my word.